This isn't the first time we've told you about research on quagga mussels in Good Harbor Bay. In fact, several years ago, some of the same researchers you just saw conducted a different experiment involving quagga mussels and another invasive species, the round goby. Great Lakes Now's Nick Austin set out to connect the dots for us.
Round gobies come from the Black and Caspian Seas and were brought to the Great Lakes in ballast water, just like zebra and quagga mussels. In fact, the mussels may have facilitated the gobies' invasion by providing an abundant food source. In the Great Lakes, the round gobies' diet consists largely of mussels.
Harvey Bootsma is a professor at the University of Milwaukee School of Freshwater Science. He and a team of researchers have discovered that the round goby may be an ally in the fight against invasive mussels.
We wanted to see if there was any potential for controlling mussels, at least at a small scale in Lake Michigan. So in 2016, with support from the National Park Service and the Great Lakes Restoration Initiative, we decided to start a mussel removal project.
The research was done on a rocky reef in Good Harbor Bay, between Leland, Michigan and Sleeping Bear National Lakeshore. There, not far from where the more recent Zequinox experiments would be done, the team took on the daunting task of removing mussels from a section of lake bottom.
The number of volunteer divers working with us spent several weeks that summer just going down diving and scraping the mussels off of rocks, trying to create a significantly large area that was mussel-free. And then after that, the objective was to monitor that to see what happened to that patch of rock.
Surprisingly, 4 years later, there are still almost no mussels in the area. The research team suspected round gobies might be responsible.
We think what's happening is the mussel larvae, or what are called veligers, settle on surfaces where they grow into hard-shelled mussels. If mussels try to recolonize these rocks, the gobies are eating them before they can grow to any significant size.
To test that hypothesis, the researchers put in devices called hastened traps, which have spaces in them that are big enough for mussels but too small for gobies.
And sure enough, we're seeing mussels in those traps now. So it does seem like the gobies are instrumental in keeping the mussels from recolonizing the rocks that we cleared some time ago.
So mussels are speeding up the deterioration of shipwrecks. But it looks like we've discovered a way to kill invasive mussels in a small section of lake bottom. And if round gobies can keep mussels out of that area by eating them, does that mean we could preserve a shipwreck by clearing out the mussels? And would gobies keep them cleared out? We wanted to know, so I asked the experts, Drs. Harvey Bootsma, Russell Cool, and Carmen Aguilar of the University of Wisconsin-Milwaukee School of Freshwater Science. How completely have the quagga mussels covered Great Lakes shipwrecks?
I would say that there's very rarely a square inch that's not covered on the outside. Inside, the holds are not nearly as heavily contaminated with mussels because they can't get food there.
What effect can these mussels have on the wrecks themselves?
So for example, one of the things is that when the little tiny villagers are creating their shell, they deposit into crevices of the wood. When they start growing, they split the wood. Then they have this mechanism to attach to shipwrecks, which is the bissel threads, and they attach to the paint very, very strongly. And so if there's a current on that, they can chip the mussels with the paint, and that starts deteriorating the shipwreck, especially if it's wood.
Another feature of the mussels is that they eat and poop all day. Bacteria that live in the crevices between the mussels turn the water anoxic by breathing all the oxygen in the water. And when they do that, they create chemicals that are capable of dissolving iron and other metal pieces of ships.
In terms of Great Lakes shipwrecks, is it possible to use Zequinox to clear mussels on Great Lakes shipwrecks?
It would be challenging for a couple of reasons. When we applied this method a couple of years ago, it was on a relatively flat lake bottom, rocky but relatively flat. So you could put this cage, so to speak, over the bottom and seal it. That would be much more difficult to do for an entire shipwreck. You might be able to do it on small sections if you could close them off completely, but it would be tough to do for an entire shipwreck. The other challenge is that to do this work, you have to have divers going down, putting all of this stuff in place. And we did our work at a depth of 10 meters, so about 33 feet. And a diver can stay at 33 feet for quite a while without running into problems of what we call decompression sickness, where you're just breathing too much compressed air over time. A lot of shipwrecks are deeper than that. So if divers have to go down deeper than that and spend quite a bit of time putting these containment systems in place, you start to run into problems of time limitations, because if a diver spends too much time down there, he or she is going to get too much nitrogen gas in the blood, and that causes problems when they come back to the surface.
If we could use Zequinox to clear mussels off of a shipwreck, would gobies keep the mussels from returning?
That's an interesting question. There again, it may depend in part on the depth of those shipwrecks. The gobies prefer to be in warmer water, and in the summer, most of the gobies are in shallow waters because those tend to be warmer. So if those shipwrecks are deep and they're constantly cold, you may not have the goby numbers on those wrecks to keep eating the mussels as fast as they are in shallower waters. But we're still learning a lot about round gobies, how they move throughout the year. We're pretty sure that a lot of them do move to deeper water in the winter. So it's possible that gobies could start eating small mussels on a shipwreck if you did clear them off of a certain area.
At Great Lakes Now, we aim to cover the Great Lakes region and the people who live here, like you. Please follow us on social media, subscribe to our YouTube channel, and sign up for our newsletter at greatlakesnow.org.